Good morning, you guys. What's up? Welcome back to Vlogmas. I woke up super early today. I've been so productive. So Sadie woke me up at 6:30 and I'm supposed to wake up for my son's school at 7:30. So I went to let her out, gave her food, praying that she would go back to sleep so I could sleep for like 45 more minutes. But do you think she did? No. She was like, Mom, I want to cuddle you. I want to play. I want to play fetch. You're not going back to bed, Mom. So I was like, all right. So I got up, organized some things today on my Google Calendar because I'm doing 2 podcast episodes later. Made Christian's lunch, you know, did a little meditation, was real productive. Imagine that. It's nice when you wake up early, you can actually get things done. What a concept. I did just go to the gym. I was going to record my full body workout for you guys, but on my second exercise, this lady walks over and she's like, ma'am, it says on the front, no filming in the gym. So I was like, my bad. I've kind of been switching between gyms and some let me film and some don't, but I never want to be like disrespectful or get like kicked out or anything. So I stopped filming. I did just go get my nails done after the gym. I got these. I was trying a gel manicure last week, but I don't know. They were just like too short and my nails were so thin. So I did get gel, like actual nails again, but they're not long at all. As you can see, they're smaller just so I can like text better, type better. When the nails are like when nails are like crazy long, like a bitch can't function. A lot of you are also asking how my new hair does holding up with sweat in the gym. I did almost 30 minutes of cardio and then just a few squats and a few easy exercises today to kind of ease back into it, because I haven't been working out too much the past month with just moving and being so busy. But my hair only sweat at the top, so I'm gonna go home and shower and I'm gonna tie up the bottom so I don't even have to wash it. I'm only really gonna wash the roots and what I need to. But this hair actually is the highest quality of real Remy human hand-tied hair possible, so it does hold up well with sweat. And as you can see, I was able to put it up in like a really high ponytail. None of the extensions like show through. It's actually pretty amazing. Like, I'm obsessed. Also, I'm wearing a brand new outfit today from Fabletics. I'm wearing this like racer back tank, and then I have, I think it's called the Alina bra on. Then I also have these new camo leggings on. They have a pocket on the side for your phone, which is really cool. I did take a clip of myself in the gym wearing this whole outfit to give you guys a more close-up preview of how everything fits. And I did pick up a package full of Fabletics activewear, which is back at home. So we're gonna get back there. I'm gonna try on every outfit for you guys. I think I got 5 outfits. And they're having a really, really awesome holiday deal that I'll have listed down below for you guys. I believe you can get 2 leggings for $24, if I'm not mistaken, which is insanity. Like, my other favorite black leggings, the Aligns, those are like $118 for 1 pair. So 2 leggings for $24 is insane. I will have the whatever holiday offer they gave me for you guys, I will have down below. And as always, because you guys watch and you're engaged with me is the reason I'm able to like work with companies and get you awesome deals and discounts. So I'm very, very grateful when you do use my links. I can highly recommend Fabletics. If you go back on my channel, like 3 years ago, I did a review for them. So it's been a real hot minute since I've been trying out their activewear. Even on my very first haul, I was super impressed. And since then, the quality of everything has definitely always improved. And they're also too a company where it's like, they have like limited edition styles. So like these camo ones and some other like holiday, like dark red leggings that I saw in there and certain things, they switch out all the time. So once like a legging or something goes active on the site, you gotta grab it because they're constantly switching patterns and stuff and nothing really stays in stock like forever, if that makes sense. But I really love these tanks too. I'll list the style name of the tank, because I wore this tank top the other day as a t-shirt, not even to work out. They sent me one in olive green and I loved it so much. It's so comfy and like it's such a thin, comfortable material to wear. I just threw it on with jeans and I made an outfit out of it like that. So you can obviously, they're meant to be workout wear, but you can just rock it on the daily as well. So anywho, it's 11:30. I just pulled up to Best Buy. We're gonna run into Best Buy real quick. I have to grab a new mic for my podcast. Then we'll get home. Christian should be there. His new nanny is gonna be there today. I don't know if she wants to be on camera, but she's super cool. She's gonna help me with him twice a week while I record the podcasts and just film for you guys and stuff. And she's such a nice lady, and she's also very education background based. So she helps Christian with like learning activities as well as nannying him. So it's like a double whammy. We got really lucky with her. We found her on care.com. So yeah, we got a lot to do today. A bitch is gonna stop rambling. I would love if you would subscribe because I'm uploading a shit ton for December and you know putting in the work. So I'd love for you guys to stay caught up on everything.
Hey guys, so it's now Sunday afternoon. I don't know where I left off this vlog, but our power just went out. I have power over here like by the Christmas tree and stuff, but up in the kitchen, all the kitchen lights just went out randomly and it has nothing to do with the breaker and none of the other lights went out in the house. So I'm like trying to figure that out. But yeah, I wanted to continue on the vlog. I told you guys earlier in the video, I was wearing a Phibletics outfit. I wanted to share with you everything that I recently got from them. First up, we have these camo leggings and this white racer back, which again are from Phibletics, and I wore into the gym today to test how they did with sweat. I love these leggings. They're super high-waisted. They kind of suck everything in, and they have the mesh paneling on the sides. The pocket on the side is big enough to hold your phone. As you can see, they're kind of like high waters. They don't go all the way down. They're just extremely comfortable. They really hold your stomach in, and I've been wearing those nonstop. Next up, I ordered this kind of like crop top slash bralette situation. I just thought it was so pretty with the dark blue and the black kind of meshed together. I really like the cut on your chest. I think it's really flattering. It doesn't show too much of your stomach. You can wear like high-waisted leggings like I am here and only have like a small portion of your midsection showing, or you could put a jacket over top. You could actually wear this outside of the gym too. I feel like it's kind of like a more formal top and it's just super cute. Black goes with everything. I think the navy blue on it, or in like purple situation it has, is like very, very pretty. Like I said, a lot of pieces are limited edition with Phibletics because they're always switching out things, but I'm going to link everything down below that's still available on the site for you guys. A lot of you also have been asking about these black leggings since I posted them on my Snapchat last week. These have become my new favorite black everyday leggings. They are so comfortable. They hold in your midsection. They're so flattering. They have a pocket on the side. I do have a huge iPhone, the 8 Plus, and it fits my phone like no problem. Again, like black goes with everything. You can see on my butt right there, they're a little dirty because I've been wearing these every day, you guys, to like drop my son off at school, to go to the gym. So comfortable. If you need just like one good staple pair of black leggings in your wardrobe, get these. I'm going to have that link below for you guys. For, you can get two leggings for 24 bucks. Literally just snag these in two colors and you're good to go. I also thought this crop top would be really cute to order just because it was a little bit different. It's got like that mesh up towards the top. We know black goes with everything. I paired it here with the camo leggings, which again, high-waisted, kind of suck you in. Like, I feel like I look really lean in this clip and I'm not. So these clothes are really doing your girl a favor. Like, they just make you look really good. I thought that crop top was just so cute. And then this one, a lot of you have asked about on my Instagram because I think it was part of the Demi Lovato collection, but I'll let you guys know down in the description if it's still available or something similar. I just thought the mesh was super unique. I didn't have anything that was long sleeve, and this one kind of had like armholes in it, and it was just mesh everywhere. You do want to wear a sports bra underneath so that the chest mesh part doesn't show through because it's like very see-through, but it's super comfortable, so stretchy, perfect for cardio or weightlifting because the material is really, really stretchy, and it has the armholes, and it was just super, super cute. So I'm going to go ahead and link the Phibletics website down below, you guys. It is actually crazy how many, like, look at this, how many styles of, like, leggings and tops that they have. I'm super grateful if you do use my link. It helps me to get more deals for you guys. So you can snag two pairs of leggings for the holidays for 24 bucks. So check that out down below.
All right, I'm about to go to the gym. Since this video is pretty much a full fitness update, I want to show you guys what I'm currently using. If you've followed my channel a while, you might know these products. First of all, how crazy do I look opening this and it's all like, first form. So you know I'm gonna use the Megawatt V2 today because I'm gonna do some cardio and some squats and some HIIT training. This is, in my opinion, the absolute best pre-workout I've tried. No crash, no jitters, you get crazy mental focus. There's tons of flavors, but I'm just gonna go ahead and use the Rocket Pop today. They did make this flavor permanent if you guys wanna grab it on the website. If you're brand new to the Megawatt, I would definitely assess your body's like tolerance to the caffeine and take half a scoop instead of one full scoop the first few times you take it, just to make sure that you're Gucci. So if you don't want something as intense as the Megawatt, you want a non-stimulant pre-workout, where is it? Come on. I would recommend for you the AlphaCree HD. Do I have another bottle of it? Maybe it's back here. If you want something a little bit less intense, maybe not for like a 40-minute HIIT workout, but maybe you want some a little bit long-lasting energy for like a two-hour sports practice or something that's not as caffeine intense, I would try the AlphaCree HD. You do get more product in this one. It's also a 30 to 60-day supply, depending how many
times a week you take it, how many times you work out. I'll leave the links for both of them down below. But I'm gonna go ahead and take a full scoop of greens powder as well before the pre-workout. I've been taking the OptiGreens almost a year now. If you can't get in your full serving of fruits and veggies every day, this is incredible. It's literally just like the best high quality greens powder I've ever tasted. Preview here. You've seen this in tons of my other videos, but just to tell you what is actually in here, it has a full fruits and veggies complex, a glycemic blend, a superfood complex with barley, grass, spirulina, wheatgrass, alfalfa grass, oatgrass, kale, spinach, parsley, a phytonutrient complex, plant enzyme blend, and a probiotic blend. So I just take one scoop. I used to take Organifi, but honestly, this is way better, guys. Oh, this one's not open. It tastes better. It goes down better. Like, it's a very finely milled powder, so you digest it really well. Okay, I have so many new ones of these since I moved. I'm like, which one is open? But yeah, it's just a greens powder, so I'll be taking a full scoop of that. And then after the gym, I always go ahead and take the Formula One, which is the post-workout protein, to basically just replace the glycogen that you've depleted during your workout. So I'm gonna get a little plastic baggie and take a full scoop of vanilla milkshake to the gym with me. You can mix with water or milk or plant-based milk, a frozen banana, whatever you do. This has 25 grams of protein per scoop. So I'm gonna do a full scoop of the Megawatt pre-workout. Just pop that in there. I don't have a water filter here yet in my new house, so I just have to use these little bottles. I'm just gonna pour that in there. I like to do as minimal water as possible to just down it like super fast. I don't do a full bottle. I'll just do like that, and then I'll down it, and then we'll head to the gym. All right, you guys, I just wanted to share a quick little booty and leg workout. I was just starting off on the Smith machine with 10 pounds on each side. I did 3 sets of 10 squats. I'm showing you one full set here of every exercise. I did go ahead and go in the racquetball room because it was empty, and I did some glute kickbacks. I did about 8 to 10 on each side. And I also did a plank. I'm not sure if I showed that here. And I just did like some walking lunges to warm up my legs. Then I went ahead and did some glute bridges here, really trying to contract my glutes and really squeeze really hard up at the top. You know, get that scrunch butt. It's not cute, but that is really what's gonna grow that muscle. I haven't done leg day in a while with moving this past month. I've been out of the gym. So even just doing these few leg exercises today really made me sore. And the next day, like, I could barely sit on the toilet. My legs and stomach and glutes have just been like literally killing. This was a pretty short workout because I had to get Christian from school, so I knocked all this out in like 30 minutes. I love doing HIIT training, as you guys know, so I'm doing some jump squats here, and I'm gonna end off with some push-ups. So I did 3 sets of this little HIIT circuit as well, and this is really what will get you sweaty. If you have minimal time, try to do some jump squats or anything with like jumping lunges that will really get your heart rate up quick. You guys know that I love HIIT circuits. You can get like a really quick workout in like 30, 40 minutes. Then I was just doing some lunges here with a knee raise, and I did end off with some stretching. If you want to go ahead and follow me over on my Instagram story, you know, I actually show even more of my workouts and like pre-workout educational information on the products, etc. So quick little workout done, got home. Then I actually made some lasagna for dinner. A lot of you were asking to show more meals in my videos. I was using this Barilla oven ready lasagna. I'm actually breaking it up into like 20 little pieces based on the pan that I'm gonna be using today. Those long noodles wouldn't actually fit, so I wanted to just break it up into tiny little pieces. I was making this a more healthy version of lasagna because I am gonna use Jennie-O ground lean Italian seasoned ground turkey, but there's a bunch of cheese on this. It's not like the healthiest meal, but it's kind of like a more healthy version than like regular lasagna, if that makes sense. Obviously, portion control, if you just have a little bit, it'll be fine. If you eat like a healthy breakfast and lunch, there's no problem with this, in my opinion, having this for dinner. Having some carbs, you know, we got the protein. I was just heating up some minced garlic there. If you want to follow this recipe at home, you're going to basically turn your pan onto medium-high heat. You're gonna pop in the ground turkey, or you could do ground beef. You could literally do anything you want. You could make vegetarian lasagna and throw a bunch of veggies in there, whatever floats your boat and is good for your family. I was actually making a bunch of extra for the week. So once the ground turkey is fully cooked, you're gonna go ahead and dump on top those lasagna noodles. You can, they're gonna be hard, that you don't want them to be cooked first or anything. That's why they say oven ready on the pack. I found them at Stater Brothers if you're curious. You basically want to cover all of the meat, but do not let these noodles get at the bottom of the pan or they will stick. Keep them on top of the meat. Then you're gonna put in one full can of Hunt's diced tomatoes. Then you're gonna put in about 1 cup of this basil red tomato sauce. Any tomato sauce you have at home will work. Put the lid over it, let it cook for 10 minutes. Then you're gonna take the lid off and you're gonna add all of your spices. I was just doing salt, garlic,
pepper, a little bit of garlic powder, and then you're going to put the lid back on for another 10 minutes. This takes a full 25 minutes to cook. Then after a full 20 minutes, you can mix everything around, and it's okay if the noodles get more towards the bottom, but you do want to constantly stir this so the noodles do not stick to the bottom of the pan, because it will just be a huge mess. So after the full 20 minutes, two 10-minute sessions of cooking, you want to get some ricotta cheese. I like to dump like big chunks of it on top, because when they melt, it kind of meshes around together and it just tastes really good. So I do like 6 or 7 big chunks of ricotta. Then I let that cook for like 2 to 3 minutes. Then you want to go ahead and add on your shredded cheese on top. You can do whatever kind your family likes. I personally like this Mexican style just because it comes with all different... Hey, Christian. He was like, Mom, is the food done? I'm hungry. What was I saying? I just dump on a bunch of cheese on top. This is where it gets kind of like unhealthy and not the best. But my family loves cheese. My mom was actually over. We were doing a little work session. So I put a bunch of cheese on top. Then I put it in the oven for 10 minutes to crisp up the cheese. Boom. Done. Easy. Amazing. Delicious. Yes, ma'am.